We are Kendrick Johnson. That's my child, and we're going to fight till it's all over, until we get the truth. That's all we've ever asked for, was the truth about what happened to Kendrick Johnson.
Jacqueline Johnson and her husband Kenneth hope to find that truth in the hundreds of hours of surveillance video recorded the day sheriff's investigators say the 17-year-old died. Look carefully. There he is, in the white T-shirt and jeans, carrying a yellow folder. The Johnsons now have this video as the result of a lawsuit. CNN filed its own motion to get access to all the video. Investigators in Lowndes County, Georgia, told the Johnsons and their attorneys that Kendrick climbed into a gym mat reaching for this shoe and that his death was an accident.
They know their child did not climb into a wrestling mat, get stuck, and die. Where is that video?
The sheriff's office says that moment was not recorded. The Johnsons also question moments in the surveillance video, like this one. Kendrick is seen running in the gym, and then another image appears showing other students. It jumps from one moment to another. The Johnsons' attorneys say they can't tell from the surveillance video what happened to Kendrick and when the other students entered.
We don't have any time code with which to synchronize the events that are shown in the video.
Either the camera did this on their own, or a human being interacted to make this camera do these things.
An attorney for Lowndes County Schools tells CNN what we produce to the sheriff is a raw feed with no edits. The attorney for Lowndes County Sheriff's Office tells CNN my client has confirmed that the video was not altered or edited by anyone within the Lowndes County Sheriff's Office.
We believe that somebody corrupted this video because it just does not make sense to us.
So, who's right? To find out, we took our copy of the video provided to CNN by the attorney for the sheriff's office to an expert. We've brought the hard drive more than 2,300 miles here to Spokane, Washington, to deliver it to the leading expert in forensic video analysis, Grant Fredericks. He's a former police officer, a consultant for the U.S. Department of Justice, and a contract instructor at the FBI Academy in Quantico. We are here to get an answer. Has the surveillance footage been altered?
Those files are not original files. They're not something that an investigator should rely on for the truth of the video.
CNN hired Frederick's company, Forensic Video Solutions, to analyze the surveillance video.
The first thing that the attorneys and the family were concerned about, they didn't see a timestamp, but you found one.
Yes.
How?
Well, the timestamp is in another stream of video, so you have to be able to access it using special codecs. So you have to really know where to find it, but it's there. Once the timestamp is located, you can then begin to make sense of it and begin to track people.
By piecing together the time codes, Frederick's team found more than 18 minutes of surveillance showing Kendrick on January 10th, starting at 7:31 a.m. as he entered school, ending the last time he was seen alive at 1:09 p.m. in the gym.
The motion video that we're looking at here and the fact that we skip time periods when there's no motion is very common. So I'm not really concerned about that part of it.
But what about the blurred image, the only angle that shows the corner where Kendrick Johnson was found dead?
The Johnsons and their attorneys believe that this was intentionally blurred to hide something. What does your expertise tell you?
Yeah, this has not been intentionally blurred. This is likely, the camera itself has probably been hit and the lens has been pushed out of focus for some reason. If you look very closely, you can see the defined lines that are inherent in digital video. Those lines are still intact, so they have not been blurred. Therefore, it was actually the lens that's blurred. The blurriness actually has the defined lines. So this is clearly just a blurred lens.
Clarity about the blur, the timestamp revealed, and an explanation for the jumpy video, which made the Johnsons and their attorneys suspicious the video had been edited. But Fredericks has a bigger concern.
But this video is not the best evidence. It's been changed and altered so that we are missing information, and what we have been provided is not the best quality.
Altered by copying, but also raising questions about whether everything was copied.